The Falkland Islands. At the end of the world, there is a lonely paradise, treeless and wild. This archipelago, in the midst of the stormy South Atlantic, provides a breeding haven for five kinds of penguin. One of these is the rockhopper. Compact and only 50 centimeters tall, it is one of the smallest of its species. The tufted yellow feathers are peculiar to this type. It is most at home in the open sea. This method of propelling itself forward preserves energy. In the breeding season between November and the middle of February, the rockhopper penguin seeks out the land. They have to negotiate ascents of over 100 meters to reach their breeding grounds. For centuries, the same stairways on the cliff face have been used. The scratch marks etched deeply into the rock bear witness to these old roots. Not even an observer can deter rockhopper penguins from pursuing their course. The breeding colony is high above the sea. The penguin couples immediately embark on the task of nest building. Every blade of grass has its place. No sooner have the two eggs been laid, the first plunderers appear. The Johnny Rook is one successful egg thief. Using its beak and razor-sharp claws, it taps a small hole in the shell. The Johnny Rook is one of the rarest birds of prey in the world. In the beginning, the rockhopper penguin chick is watched over by the slightly larger adult male. The parents care for the nestling with tenderness. Dirt is removed from its down. The adult birds have to undertake an arduous journey every day in order to catch krill and cuttlefish for the young. Descending to sea level becomes a small adventure. Stone slabs are negotiated by a surfing technique. If it becomes too steep, the only thing to do is to jump. They dive into the sea in small groups. The rockhopper penguins travel as far as 40 kilometers inland and can dive to depths of 100 meters. In the absence of their parents, chicks form into groups of about 20. In this kindergarten, guarded by adults, the chicks are secure and protected. The adults return from their successful hunt for krill and cuttlefish. Before the climb back, they indulge themselves with an extended bath. King cormorants live in close proximity to the rockhopper penguins. More and more groups arrive. The penguins hop up the steps in the rock face, one after the other. Their sharp claws give them vital purchase. Now that the first hurdles have been cleared, they take time to groom themselves. Halfway up, there is a small waterfall. Everyone wants first turn. After a shower, the ascent continues. Their ability to jump is extraordinary. They measure the distance with their beaks before they leap. The cliff has been tackled, and already the pleading cries of the chicks can be heard in the distance. They recognize each other by the sounds they make. The young bird is not immediately fed. First, it has to prove its fitness. It is only in years of plenty that two chicks are raised. The feeding process is triggered by tapping the beak. While the ever-hungry chicks are being fed by one parent, the other is already in search for more food. In these southern reaches, the weather is highly unpredictable. Wind gusts of over 80 kilometers an hour sweep over the island. At such times, a bird like this Magellan penguin can lose its bearings. When the sea gets rough, the ascent becomes quite an adventure. At twilight, calmness returns. It is the beginning of February, and the chicks have become fledglings. The flying class for the king cormorants can begin. And the down coat of the rockhopper penguin chicks is exchanged for one of compact feathers. Only the shock of yellow tufts is missing. The adults begin to molt. During this period, they are completely tied to the land. The new feathers push the old ones out, so the penguins never have to stand around freezing without any feathers. They lose up to 40% of their weight during the molting season. The These landlubbers stand for hours on the same spot so that they expend as little energy as possible. The descent of the inexperienced youngsters is spectacular. What they lack in experience, they have to make up for in courage. What might be the simplest way? They don't yet know the best way down. With some trepidation, the journey continues. Timid, but fascinated, this little penguin observes the sea for the first time in its life. A small company has already arrived. With great curiosity, they watch the waves of that great unknown, the sea. They regard the first ocean spray with awe. After several hours, the bravest moves forward. And the others follow. From the moment that the first ocean spray touches the glossy feathers of the young birds, their excitement is unstoppable. The atmosphere is electric. The young king cormorants make their last preparations before heading off. Now the flight over the ocean begins. It has become lonely in the penguin colony. A last glimpse of the land. This is the beginning of the oceanic phase, which lasts from April to October. All that is left are feathers and the trampled pathways of the rockhopper penguins. Only two sounds can be heard, the constant whistling of the wind and the roar of the sea.